Happy and blessed New Year. It's great to be in the house of the Lord today. No announcements. As of yet, we'll see what happens going forward. And praise God. Hallelujah. I hope you came expecting to receive today. And for those that will be listening or watching after, I pray God will bless you and minister to you, not only as we worship, but as in the message. And I believe God's got a message for his people. I've been saying this for weeks and for months now, all through the difficult times that the Christians and believers to see what's happening in the world and what's taking place in people's lives. But I believe God is lifting up his people. I believe that he's encouraging us and strengthening us that we might be strong vessels for him. So I encourage each and every person today that God is still on the throne. And if you're listening or watching this later and you're unable to be here, praise God, and I pray God minister to those that are able to be here today. Let's open in prayer. Lord, I thank you today, Lord, that your presence makes us whole. And Lord, I pray today as we're about to worship you, Lord, that you would fill this house with your glory, that you would fill this house with your anointing. I pray that each and every person that comes through the doors, Lord, would feel the presence of your Holy Spirit. And Lord, that you would minister in a powerful way, touching lives, changing lives. Lord, I thank you for it today. I praise you for it. And Lord, I pray a hedge of protection on each and every person in this place today. I pray, Lord, all the believers and saints, Lord, that you would strengthen and encourage them. Let your anointing just flow through this house. Minister, I pray in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Let's worship the Lord together. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. We worship your name, Lord. You are worthy to be praised, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship your name, Lord. Ooh, glory to God. We worship your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship your name, Lord.
Sickness.
Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. And today, Lord, I pray, Lord, you would, Lord, replenish the joy of the Lord that gives us strength. Lord, I pray today, Lord, all fear be gone in the name of Jesus. I pray today, Lord, that you would empower your saints, Lord, that we would arise and go forth in the name of Jesus. For you have conquered every foe. And Lord, I just thank you and praise you that whatever, Lord, our needs may be, today, Lord, whatever it is, if it's financial, Lord, if it's something hard or heavy in our heart, Lord, if it's something that's bothering us in our mind, Lord, whatever the case may be, I pray, Lord Jesus, the power of God would make it right. The power of God, Lord, would touch today. In Jesus' name, I pray the power of God would answer. And Lord, I pray today, Lord, would be a new day. I pray, Lord Jesus, that our loving arms that you have spoken about in the Holy Spirit that moved in this place would just wrap your people, Lord. Wrap them, Lord, in your arms today. Lord, I pray for every need in this body, today in this place, whatever it may be. And Lord, we just lift it up to you. You said, come to me, all of you who are heavy laden and burdened, and I will give you rest. And today, Lord, I pray, we lift our burdens at Calvary, where by your stripes we were healed. Lord, I lift every burden at Calvary today. For every sin was taken to the cross. Every ailment, every infirmity. And though, Lord, we are human enough, Lord, we are certainly not perfect. We come to you, Lord, humbly in expectation, Lord, that you are the rewarder of those that will diligently seek you. And we seek your face today, Lord, that you might work in our lives, that you might be, Lord, our strong tower, that the righteous run to where we are safe, we are rebuilt, we are retooled, we are strengthened, we are encouraged. You are our shield, Lord, our strong tower, our deliverer, our portion, our very present help in time of need. And Lord, I pray today, for miracles. I sense the overwhelming power of your presence in this place today. Lord, and I don't take it lightly. I don't take it for granted. I thank you, Lord, that you are faithful when we come together to worship you, Lord, when we come together to seek your face. Lord, I thank you and praise you for the power of your presence, for truly the presence of your Holy Spirit is in this place. And I pray, Lord, that we would be open vessels, that we would have an ear to hear. And Lord, we would receive all that you have, including that healing, including that touch, including that blessing, including that direction, including that instruction, and whatever the case may be. I pray today, Lord, that we would be open-minded, open-hearted, and that we would receive from you as your Holy Spirit is in this place and is pouring out into the lives of your people. I pray that we would receive it today, Lord. Lord, pressed down, shaken together, running over into our lives. I thank you for it. I praise you for it. We ask all of this, Lord, in the powerful name of Jesus. And everybody in this house agreed with me and said, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, worship team. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Though Satan rages, we will not be defeated. You know, I've watched, listening and reading and so many devotions, and as I read the scripture, the Lord has just been definitely speaking to us about Jehoshaphat and the example that Jehoshaphat is for our lives. And 3 weeks ago, I mentioned that last week I would mention an encouraging letter I received from one of our missionaries. We receive many encouraging words, so I don't want you to think that that they don't, but many of them send encouraging, and they're on the back wall when we get them. I have them placed on the wall over by the table, so if you want to, if you're ever back there, that's where all those papers are hanging up there. If you have a minute, you want to take a look at it. But today, I just felt that what our brother Terry Rosh, who's a missionary to Panama that we support, and I think he was here a couple years ago, and he was itinerating, and he sent this message in email and a letter in his report, and I want to read that because it fits in. Today I want to speak about hope continually in the Lord and praise Him more and more. Hope continually in the Lord and praise Him more and more. And just as He does so faithfully every week, He has already confirmed this message and taken parts of it right out that it must be our specifically He wants us to hear, because He's spoken specific message things right out of this message already in the interpretation of the tongues. And you know, I don't know, I don't take it for granted, but I get excited when God confirms, when the Holy Spirit confirms that, yes, Pastor, you heard from me. So I like to hear that, and I am so excited when He does that, because I know that it's a message that God wants us to hear. Because I don't just want to stand up here and be an orator and give you something that's just, because if it's words without the life of the Holy Spirit, it's just words. But I want to give you the breath of God. I want to give you what God wants us to hear. Hope continually in the Lord and praise Him more and more. In a moment, we'll go to 2 Chronicles for this, but I want to read this letter. And I want you to think about yourself, and maybe we felt the same way in some of the things that he speaks here. Recently, I was sitting and reflecting over the past several months. This life I am living is not what I thought, where I thought I would be at this moment. In that moment, I felt sadness. I felt frustration. I even felt anger at the loss of what I thought I should be doing for the Lord at this moment. And many thoughts were running through the simple mind of mine. I'm sure no one can associate with that. Then God started to show me something I wasn't expecting. He started showing me flags. In life, there are various flags that we see. Some make declarations, others give warnings. The Panamanian flag, he is a missionary to Panama. The white stands for peace and purity, and the blue star stands for the purity and honesty of life of the country. The red star represents the authority and law of the country, and together the stars stand for the new republic. The U.S. flag, the stripes represent the original 13 colonies, and the stars represent the 50 states of the Union. Red symbolizes the hardiness and valor. White symbolizes the purity and innocence. And blue represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice. Some organizations have a flag to represent their beliefs or the people they support. International Society of Missionary Kids, the blue section of the flag represents missionary kids' passport culture. The yellow section represents the new culture. The chameleon in the middle is named Nico, and he represents missionary kids who often feel like they don't belong to one single culture, but rather are blending of them. That is why missionary kids are represented by the green chameleon, who signifies their ability to adapt to their surroundings and blend into the culture they are living in at the time. When chaos strikes, many of us think of a red flag warning of the danger. I am sure many of us feel the urge of waving a red flag to the world around us, especially over the past several months. With the chaos I have been encountering, I would love to wave the red flag for everyone around me to see. But I have instead decided to wave a white flag. The white flag is one we associate with surrender. And I am surrendering to the chaos and to God as I try to discover the good that He will bring from the chaos. I understand that God may choose not to remove me from the chaos, but rather bring me through it. Our journey has not been an easy one, but I will never doubt that God is still God, even in the midst of the storms of life. I choose to remember and have faith in the fact that God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Even when God does not answer my prayers the way I want Him to, I trust Him. Isaiah 55:8, my thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord, and my ways are far beyond anything you can imagine. Think about it, if the disciples, how many times have we heard this example? Think about it, if the disciples, with their narrow vision, had their prayer answered the way they thought best, Jesus would not have died and would not have rose again, making a way for us. Their vision was smaller than God's. He can see the whole picture, the beginning and the end. And I may not be able to understand the whys in this lifetime, and it may not be until I stand before God that I finally have the clarity to understand all that He has transpired. But until that day, I choose to trust and have faith in the One who holds the world in His hands. God speaks to me and brings peace to me through worship. I can associate with that. As we close out 2020, I pray that you are able to rest in the fact that we serve a living God. Over 2,000 years ago, He came to earth in the form of a baby, knowing full well what would happen, but offering us hope. He also knows each of our trials, and He's standing with us and will continue to stand with us, whatever we may face, giving us hope. And that goes along with the rest of the message. So now let's go to 2 Chronicles. And you know, I thought in the beginning, everyone in this building, I'm sure, and those that might be listening or watching this can attest to probably feeling frustration, anger, and so many different emotions about what has taken place in 2020. And whatever God has for 2021. So today, I want to talk about hoping continually in the Lord and praising Him more and more. 2 Chronicles 20, verse 1 tells us this: after this, the Moabites and the Ammonites, with some of the Munites, came to wage war against Jehoshaphat. Some people came and told Jehoshaphat, a vast army is coming against you from Edom, from the other side of the Dead Sea. It's already in Hazen Tamar, that is in En-Gedi. Alarmed, Jehoshaphat resolved to inquire of the Lord, and he proclaimed a fast for all of Judah. The people of Judah came together to seek help from the Lord. Indeed, they came from every town of Judah to seek Him. Lord, I thank You today for the power of Your Holy Spirit. I thank You that You have confirmed this message today for us. And Lord, I thank You that You are here to strengthen us, to encourage us, to give us a lively hope, as Peter spoke about. Lord, I pray today that this lively hope would be alive in us. And Lord, that it would just strengthen and encourage Your people to look to You, Lord, the author and the finisher of our faith. Lord, I pray that You would hide me behind the cross as I deliver this message. Let the words that come out of my mouth be Yours and not mine, Lord. We came to hear what You have to say. And I ask this in Jesus' precious name, and everybody in the house said, amen. Amen. A little background on Jehoshaphat. And I will tell you, I like to share this, that when I was doing the background here, I think the Lord gave me next week's message too. So, praise the Lord. In chapter 18 of 2 Chronicles, it tells us that Jehoshaphat was a man of great wealth and honor. And Jehoshaphat was king of Judah. And unfortunately, he allied himself with the evil king of Israel, Ahab. And if we recall, Ahab and Jezebel, his wife, queen, were evil, wicked rulers that were rebelling against God. And as the Bible would say, did evil in the sight of the Lord. Did they ever do evil? They were idol worshipers. And they had idol worship, false prophets. And they were evil, as evil could be. But you see, Jehoshaphat's son, Jehoram, had married Ahab and Jezebel's daughter, Ophelia. And there was a bond there that was created. And one day, Ahab came to Jehoshaphat and he said to him, "Hey, would you go help me? I want to attack Ramoth Gilead." And Jehoshaphat said, "Sure, I'll help you. My people are your people and your people are mine, and we're all just, we are together, and we'll just go off together and we'll do this together." So, I don't want to go into the story, but if you don't recall the story, it's pretty interesting to see what happens. You know, people say, "Oh, just the Old Testament or whatever," but the Old Testament prepares for the New Testament. And there's stories of great faith to encourage us there and to show us how God works and to show us that nothing is new under the sun and that what takes place in deception and the things that while they may have been primitive back then, they're still taking place today, maybe just in a higher technological form. But Jehoshaphat helps out Ahab, and Ahab, fortunately, is killed in this battle. And Jehoshaphat returns back to his palace in chapter 19, and he is confronted by one of the seers in the palace. And this is what he says to Jehoshaphat. "Should you help the wicked and love those who hate the Lord? Because of this, the wrath of the Lord is on you. There is, however, some good in you, for you have rid the land of the Asherah poles and have set your heart on seeking God." See, Jehoshaphat was destroying all of the idols. And he was instructing all the leaders that they are to do right by the Lord, and they are to judge honestly with integrity. And he established the leaders and the judges, and he said that you need to lead with integrity, you need to lead under the commands of God, and you need to follow God's precepts and be very careful how you lead. Yet, in doing so, the Moabites, the Ammonites, were attacking Judah. And the people came to Jehoshaphat and they said, "There's a vast army that's coming against you from Edom, from the other side of the Dead Sea, and it's already in Hazen Tamar that is in Gedi." But I want you to see today as I go through this, how it correlates with what we may be experiencing, what believers in the church may be experiencing today. I want you to see first that Jehoshaphat was alarmed. He was frightened. The scripture says so. And what he did was he sought the Lord. Jehoshaphat was alarmed, and he sought the Lord. Verse 3 tells us, alarmed in the NIV, Jehoshaphat resolved to inquire the Lord. And he proclaimed a fast for Judah. He was alarmed and frightened, and he inquired of the Lord. And I thought to myself, as I was going through this, who do we inquire of when we are alarmed? When life circumstances might cause fright in us? When we're faced with opposing forces or circumstances that seem to spell certain defeat, seem to, notice the key words there. Who is it that we call upon? Who is it that we inquire? itself, who do we inquire and what is our reaction? Down in the verse 10, this is the prayer of Jehoshaphat. I want you to get excited about this too, because this is God's message for his people today. This is God's message for believers. Jehoshaphat says, but now here are men from Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, whose territory you would not allow Israel to invade when they came from Egypt. So they turned away from them and did not destroy them. See how they are repaying us by coming to drive us out of the possession you gave us as an inheritance. Verse 12. Our God, will you not judge them? I want you to underline this or highlight this or put this in. For we have no power to face this vast army that is attacking us. We do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. Glory to God. God, will you not judge them? Anybody here ever had that thought about what's happening? Lord, won't you change things? Won't you make things right? For we have no power to face this vast army. We do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. Jehoshaphat recognized that they did not have the power to overcome the advancing armies. He recognized it. He said, we don't have the power to fight these advancing armies. He recognized that he could not overcome the circumstances on their own. He recognized that although they lacked what was needed for the crisis of the day, that God is never lacking whatever crisis might be in our way. God is never lacking, and he recognizes that. And he says to him, God, we have no idea what to do, but our eyes are on you. It's a rhyme, too. God, we have no idea what to do, but our eyes are on you. I want you to see that key right there. And I want you to understand that I believe God is saying to the church today, you may not know exactly what to do. We do, in some respect, praise, worship, pray, and go through. But our eyes are on the Lord. Our eyes should be on him. And we may be feeling like, you know, there might be, other than just what's happening in the world today, there might be circumstances in our own lives where we say, Lord, I just don't know what to do with this. I don't know anymore how to go proceed. I don't even know what. I see what's ahead of me, and I just don't know what to do. I want you to see what Jehoshaphat is seeing, and I want you to understand, if you put it in our realm today, there's advancing armies, and they're coming after you. And you know what else I noticed? And although the Lord said the wrath was on him, he was doing, he still did what was right in the sight of the Lord. Even though he made that mistake where they had in the beginning. Even though he, just like Cuban, made a mistake, he continued, he didn't say, well, I messed up, God's wrath is on me, I might as well live it up then and forget the whole thing and then I'll just do what I want to do then. I'll be evil like Ahab and Jezebel were. No. He did what was right in the sight of the Lord. He destroyed idols. He told the people, this is, you need to live like for God. And he told the leaders, you need to lead and judge and really be careful and be with integrity. And he did all that. Yet, it seemed like, you know, everything was right. Yet, struggles came. Yet, armies are advancing. You ever feel like you're doing everything right, yet things just come against you anyways? Because we're not alone. You ever feel like you're doing what God wants you to do and there's vast armies forming? Well, they're forming. There's no question about it. But I want to reiterate this that I've been saying. I know what is seen was not made out of what is visible. And then verse 6, and without faith it's impossible to please God. Because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. Jehoshaphat believed in God. He believed in the power of his God. He believed in his power, in God's power, and his ability to handle the situation at hand. And therefore, Jehoshaphat sought the Lord. And what's the message for us today, saints? Seek the Lord. We look around at the circumstances. We look around and we see, you know, some people said, well, goodbye 2020. Well, I got news for you. In the world, 21 doesn't look any better yet. In the world. Not in God's eyes, maybe. But I'm not seeing any good other than our hope in Jesus and our hope in our Lord and Savior. In this world, I'm not seeing any. You know, I'm not a pessimist. Oh, that preacher here, I'll listen to him. I'm not prophesying negative things either. I'm not saying this prophetically. I'm just saying, with my human eyes, I'm not seeing anything better happening in 21 yet. We're in a couple days now, right? And something's the worst with my human eyes.
And see the deliverance of
down tomorrow against them, you will not fight this battle. Take your positions, people. Stand firm and see the deliverance of the Lord will give you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do not be afraid. Don't be discouraged. Go out to face them, and the Lord will be with you. Do not be afraid. I keep saying, do not be discouraged. Go out to face them tomorrow. The Lord will be with you. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, yes, I know, he holds the future. And life is worth the living just because he lives. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Glory to God. The Lord spoke this to me. And I think I mentioned it slightly one time before, but he hasn't fixed my memory yet, so I can't remember if I did. Maybe there's a reason for that, but whatever. In Exodus chapter 13, when Pharaoh let the people go, God did not lead them on the road to the Philistine country, though that was shorter. For God said if they faced war, they might change their minds and return to Egypt. So God led the people around by the desert road towards the Red Sea. The Israelites went up out of Egypt ready for battle. In verse 21, by day the Lord went ahead of them in a pillar of a cloud to guide them on their way. And by night in a pillar of a fire to give them light so that they could travel by day or night. Neither the pillar of the cloud by day nor the pillar of the fire by night left its place in front of the people. And saints, this is what the Lord said to me. And he just revealed something to me as I was reading that. They didn't understand, I'm sure, why they were taking the long way. The scripture says that God understood why he had to take them the long way. God understands why the situations in the world are happening the way they are. God understands why we may be facing in our own personal circumstances what we are. He understands it, and we may not know why. But we got to open our eyes to him, and we got to look to him as Jehoshaphat did. We got to inquire of the Lord. And he spoke this to me. It might not be a fire, but it might be. It might not be a cloud, but it may be. But he is showing a sign to his people to follow. He is giving us communication. He is giving us signs and wonders to follow, just like the fire and the cloud. He is saying to us that if we will look to him, we will see the supernatural signs that will cause us to go in the way that he will cause us to go. He will give us signs that will give us direction, that will give us instruction. It may not be a pillar of fire, it may not be a cloud, but the supernatural signs of God are coming and are here to direct his people if we will open our eyes to the Lord. If we will open our eyes and look to him, he will give us the signs.
Yeah.
He spoke that to me several weeks ago, and it just didn't really fit, but it fits today. God's answer to Jehoshaphat, when Jehoshaphat said, rightfully so, just as we can say today, Lord, we don't have in our own being, without you, what it takes, what you do. In our eyes, we don't know what to do sometimes, most of the time. And our eyes are on you, we're looking for direction. And he's saying to us, just as he led the children of Israel, and just as it seemed wacky and crazy the way he led them, the long way, the hard way, oh Lord, he's going to lead his people. And we need to be open. We need to have, be seeking the Lord, and he will show us the signs. He will show us the cloud to direct us in the fire. And whatever the case may be, what is that symbol? He has not told me. And what will it be individually or corporately? I don't know. But he is saying that he is showing his way. way than the way for us to go. If we will say to the Lord, we don't know what to do, and put our eyes on Him, He will tell us when to fight. He will tell us when to stand still. I think we already heard that for now. He will tell us when to watch. He will tell us when to go forward. He will tell us when to wait for Him. He will tell us when to speak. He will tell us when to hush. We don't have the power to fight this battle. We don't have what we ought, and we don't know what we ought to do. Saints, but let's put our eyes on the One who does. Let's put our eyes on the One who does. I want you to get this. I want you to really put the parallel here. It may seem like a vast army is forming against you, us. And I don't just mean us here at First Assembly. I mean the church in general. The true church of Jesus Christ. True believers. But our God is greater and more than able to handle the situations of this world, because He already overcame the world. Remember, He told us that. Be of good cheer. I've already overcome the world. And here's one of my favorite parts. They praised in the battle. And you know, the Lord has been speaking about this Jehoshaphat for weeks, and I've read and read and read. And I will say to you too that as I was just reading the scripture the other day, and the Lord brought to me again that He is going to bring rivers in the desert. He is making straight crooked paths. He's making the way where there seems to be no way. Because He is on the move. He is on the move. And He's not a God that He should lie. But His people will receive His power and will be empowered. And this is what He's calling us to do. As Jehoshaphat did, to seek Him. He'll give us our answer. And then we need to praise Him in the battle. Verse 20 says, early in the morning, they left for the desert of Tekoa. And as they set out, Jehoshaphat stood and said, listen to me, Judah and the people of Jerusalem. This is awesome. Have faith in the Lord your God, and you will be upheld. Have faith in His prophets, and you will be successful. And after consulting the people, Jehoshaphat appointed men to sing to the Lord and to praise Him for the splendor of His holiness. And as they went out ahead of the army, saying, give thanks to the Lord, for His love endures forever. As they began to sing and praise the Lord set ambushes against the men of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir, who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. And the Ammonites and the Moabites rose up against the men from Mount Seir to destroy and annihilate them. And after they finished slaughtering the men from Seir, they helped to destroy one another. And when the men of Judah came to take place that overlooks the desert and looked toward the vast army, they saw only dead bodies laying on the ground. No one had escaped. God is God. He's God in the Amen corner. He's God in the pew. He's God on the platform, and He's God all over you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want you to see that they believed in the prophecy. See, are you hearing this? They believed in the prophecy. And what did Jehoshaphat say? Listen to me! Have faith in the Lord and what He said to us. Saints, I'm calling you today, and those listening and those watching, have faith in the Lord. Have faith in the Lord and what He said. Even though it doesn't look like it's taking place, even though it doesn't look like He's still in control, give you. Trusting in the Lord and not your own strength or understanding. You know. Is this not what God has been speaking to us? I'm going to see a victory, for the battle belongs to the Lord. What has he been saying to us? And they acted on their belief in the prophecy that had been spoken. Jehoshaphat had the choir singing praises, leading the army into battle. Men singing praises to God as they entered into battle. As they were singing, the Lord set ambushes on the enemy's army. And in addition to trusting, having faith in him, it's his battle. We're not fighting a carnal battle, people, but spiritual. And what God has been telling us, worship me, praise me, praise me. Let's praise into battle, saints. Let's praise into battle. Let's praise into battle. Glory to God. I'm going to close with this. Actually, today, I'm going to do a little something different. So I'm going to ask the whole worship team to come up, because we're going to praise into battle. That's how we're going to close today. All creatures of our God and King. But before we get there, you know, I have to tell you this, because God just, yesterday I read, as I was finishing this up, before I read that, I went through and I get devotional emails, I tell you that, from different sources, and this scripture was in there, and it sums up all of what took place, and you'll be surprised to know that it comes from the Book of Psalms. When it comes. This is what the psalmist said in Psalm 71. And this is where my title came from today. You'll hear it. In thee, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be put to confusion. Deliver me in thy righteousness and cause me to escape. You can all make your way up. Go ahead. You up. Incline thine ear unto me and save me. Be thou my strong habitation whereunto I pray continually. Resort thou hast given command to save me, for thou art my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, O my God, out of the hand of the wicked, out of the hand of the unrighteous and the cruel man. For thou art my hope, O Lord. Thou art my trust from my youth. By thee have I been holden up from the womb. Thou art he that took me out of my mother's bowels, and my praise shall be continually of thee. I am as a wonder unto many, but thou art my strong refuge. Let my mouth be filled with thy praise and thy honor in all the day. Cast me not off in the time of old age. Forsake me not when my strength faileth. For mine enemies speak against me, and they that wait for my soul take counsel together, saying, God hath forsaken him. Persecute and take him, for there is none to deliver him. O God, be not far from me. O my God, make haste for thy help. Let them be confounded and consumed that are adversaries to my soul. Let them be covered with reproach and dishonor that seek my hurt. And here's the two verses. But I will hope continually and will yet praise thee more and more. My mouth shall show forth thy righteousness and thy salvation all the day. For I know not the numbers thereof. I will go in the strength of my God, the Lord God. I will make mention of thy righteousness, even of thy own. You know, saints, we are faced with what seems like insurmountable circumstances, a world so crazy and upside down. When faced with fearful, uncertain circumstances, who are you going to call? When faced seek the Lord, and you will find him. He will answer and provide the direction. There is a representative cloud and a representative fire for his people, a sign. And there can be no question that God is calling his people to praise him as we head into battle. And I want you to see the parallels here of the Jehoshaphat and what is happening to believers today. I want you to see that so many forces seeming to mount against Christianity and believers. It seems as though so much ground has already been gained against us. It seems as though so much ground has already been gained against Christianity and believers. But saints, let's take the example of Jehoshaphat. Let's inquire the Lord. Let's hear his examples. Or let's take his example. Let's hear from the Lord. And let's receive from him. When you're up against a struggle that shatters all your dreams, and your hopes have been cruelly crushed by Satan's manifested schemes, don't let the faith you're standing on in seem to disappear. Praise the Lord. He can work through those who praise him. Praise the Lord. For God inhabits praise. Praise the Lord. For the chains that seem to bind you serve only to remind you that they drop powerless behind you when you praise him. Praise the Lord. Now Satan is a liar. And he wants to make you think that you're paupers, poor, wounded souls, when you're really children of the King. So here it is. Lift up the mighty shield of faith, saints. For the battle must be won. We know that Jesus Christ is risen. So the work's already done. Praise the Lord! He can work through those who praise him. Praise the Lord. For our God inhabits praise, praise the Lord. For the chains that seem to bind you serve only to remind you that they drop powerless behind you when you praise him. Saints, open our eyes. Jehoshaphat said, Lord, this vast army is forming against us, and we don't have the power to fight this army. And we look around and we see this vast, and it's closing. And when the Lord showed, he said, and it seems as though they've gained so much ground. But it's time for the people of God to stand firm on the shield of faith. For the battle must be won. Jesus Christ is alive. So the work is already done. Praise the Lord. He works through those who praise him. So turn to him. Put our eyes on him as Jehoshaphat did. Put our eyes on him and let him who have an ear hear what the Spirit would say to him. And I'll encourage you that I think next week it's going to be about that the majority isn't always right. The majority isn't always right. And if you go back a couple chapters in 2 Chronicles, you'll figure out what I'm talking about. Glory to God, because it applies to us today. Let's stand and sing. Praise the Lord, all creatures of our God and King. Glory to God.
All creatures of our God and King. Glory to God. today in Jesus' name. All creatures of
it's time for saints, Lord, to trust in the Lord.
Turn your face forward and give them peace. In Jesus' name I pray.